Jesús resucitó. Wow.
Si pequé, después de convertirme, pues perdón, yeah. ¿Cómo no entregarte este don? Yo quiero ese galardón que está prometiéndome tu palabrón. Rompe las cadenas, rompe el eslabón. Lávame con tu sangre. Desde que te tengo a ti me siento cangre. Tu palabra es pan de vida y tengo hambre. Sansón se comió el pan al
cielo. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So, as you can tell by the title, this video is on how to get a job at Foot Locker. So, first of all, you gotta really think. Are you ready for this job? Cause let me tell you, everybody be saying that this job is fun and all, it's cool and all, but sometimes it's quick paced. First off, are you ready to run back to go get all the sneakers you need? Are you good at remembering all the sizes, specific sneaker you need, the color code, all the stuff, and remembering where they are? Are you fast at doing all that? Keep that in mind. If you say yes to all those things, or you know you will be, and you will be working on it, and you'll be good in no time, go ahead, sis. Go ahead, do it. So, one, actually being able to apply to the job. So a lot of people tell you, yeah, you could go on all these third party apps, like job apps that you could apply through there. Let me tell you something. No, do not do that. Number one, no, do not do that. Go straight to the Foot Locker website. I'll put a screenshot right here of what it looks like. So you want to go straight to the website, because third party apps, I don't explain it, but a lot of people that I know that applied through a third party app, they did not get accepted, and I got a call in like within a week. So, and I didn't apply through that. So go straight to the website, the Foot Locker employees website, or whatever it's called, which will, I'll put a picture right here. Put your information in. You do not need no work experience. You do not need work experience, as long as you have good qualities. So after you apply, what I did was I called the store which I applied for, and I asked them, I called them and somebody answered, and I asked them if I could talk to the manager. First thing, it was wrong, right? So it was like, oh yeah, we'll just call you in no time, whatever, da da da. And it wasn't really the manager, it was probably assistant manager, somebody, I don't know who it was. But so I was like, all right. So I think a few days go by again, and I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna call again, because I know I ain't tripping. So I call and I'm like, oh hey, I know I talked to you before, and they're like, no, you didn't talk to me, whatever. Point is, I got to actually talk to the manager, and the manager told me that she would be checking the everybody who applied, and she'll be calling certain people, you know, doing her thing. So I got a call like 2 days later after that, and she was like, hey, can you come into an interview for like 1 o'clock, I think it was, a 3, something like that. So I went to an interview. A lot of people say don't dress like crappy, but do not dress overdressed, you know what I mean. I would look for some old jeans that I used to wear back then, my crazy stuff. So I got some black jeans, my nines, my Jordan nines, and I had my hair in a bun. Mind you, my hair was messy, it was raining that day, it was not it, but I made it on time to my interview, because I was waiting for the bus and the bus did not come on time, or either I was late, one of those soon. So I was like, damn, I gotta spend bread on the Uber, you know, I don't got all my bread up there like that time, you know, so I'm trying to, that's why I'm trying to get time, you know. So I called an Uber, I got there like 3 minutes right before my interview supposed to start, and I go in. The actual interview, a lot of people will say that they ask you a lot of questions, da 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 da. Number one thing you want to know that usually a lot of Foot Locker managers are looking for is customers. Customer satisfaction, always number one. That's still like priority type stuff. So, I didn't get a lot of questions asked to me the like interview. So I got there, the manager, we just started, like, she starts asking me like, oh, how's your day? What you been up to? Like, chill stuff. Like, it was a regular conversation. So I, you know, I was just low-key chatting it up. So then we get to sit down, and she's part of the interview, because that was what I wanted to see. I wanted to see what your personality was like. So I was like, oh snap, that's valid, because if it wasn't for that, it wouldn't look cute. But so that's the first part, she wanted to see what my personality was like. Then she had a box, she gave me a box of Vans, and she was like, look at the box, tell me what you see about the box. So I saw that one pair was I and the other one was dirty, like it was dirty. So I told her, oh, one is dirty, da da. So she's like, okay, so that's the last pair we have, the customer really wants it, but what do you do? Do you tell them that you see the stain on it and that you don't got no more? Or, like, what do you do? So, you know, I'm thinking, I saw a video before this, like, before, you know, I was trying to prepare myself. And it was the girl was talking about money. So I was like, all right. So I was like, you know, I'm a kind of tell him. I'm gonna be like, yeah, you sure? Like, I'm gonna show her the shoe. I'm like, are you sure? Like, you know, yeah, this is pretty shoe. You know, do you want to buy it or not? Like, it was valid. You could buy it still. I wouldn't really tell her specifically, like, straight up, like, yeah, you know, it's dirty, da da da. So that's what I said. And she was like, that's kind of wrong. That's wrong, actually. That's not kind of wrong. That's wrong because you're going to tell the customer that the shoe is dirty because we don't want them to come back and then say they have a problem with it and we sold them a dirty sneaker and, you know, all that. So I honestly said the answer because I saw the video before, but that's not really what I would have done. So I told her, I was like, nah, you know, in reality, like, since I go with my mom to Macy's a lot, they always say they don't have this specific clothes or whatever, like, good and all that in the store at the time. Then they could order it for us and then we get it ordered, like, shipped to the house. So, like, if we could do that Foot Locker, I didn't know at that time. So I was like, if we could do that Foot Locker, that's what I would say. Like, and I would tell her that it's dirty because I wouldn't buy that myself. And then she was like, so, yeah, basically that's correct because you wouldn't sell a sneaker like that to your family, you know? So, you know what I mean? You wouldn't want somebody to sell you a sneaker like that. So why would you do it to somebody else? Boom. So basically it was customer satisfaction, your personality. If you are shy, let me tell you something. You gotta get out your shell because, baby, you gotta interact with the customers. You gotta, like, low-key have a good relationship with customers. Customers will remember you if they come back to the store. They'll be like, yo. So last time, they will bring up, like, old things that y'all were talking about, like, fits and all that, sneakers and all that. Like, it really is valid. Then from there, on the spot, she told me I was hired, that I could come and work, like, next week. So on the spot, she said I was hired because she liked my personality, how I was, so all that. So do not be fake. Do not fake it. Really be yourself. Do not fake it. Impress the manager. Be yourself. Trust me on this one. Don't be like, oh, damn. I remember the video. She was like, oh, it's always this. Nah. Be yourself. Trust me. If it's yourself, you valid. So, yeah, that's how you get a job at Foot Locker. Now, if you guys want another video of me explaining how it is to work at Foot Locker, in the comments below. And I got y'all. So, yeah, and I also did this video because it was, oh yeah, as y'all don't see, this is my Foot Locker shirt, it has my name on it, y'all see that? So, oh yeah, 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 but yeah, so I did this video because I always had, like, questions for people. I, like, not even for, like, I just wanted a job. I always wanted a job. Oh, look at my hair, y'all. Y'all see my hair? Yo, all right. Nah, but seriously, when I would ask people, like, to put me on, to help me out, like, they wouldn't to help me out. So I would always be like, yo, like, when I get a job and I know what's up with it, like, I would want to help other people out. Like, that's wild greed. Like, why would you do that? Why would you not help other people out? People have necessities. Like, but yeah. So if y'all want part two to what it's like to work at Foot Locker, let me know in the comments below. And if y'all like the video, give it a thumbs up. So, see y'all next time.